Hello everyone, welcome to Sai Niketan online classes. In our previous class we are discussing about linear programming problem. In that we are solving the problem on exercise 12.2. in that we have question number 6, right? So a cottage industry manufactures pedestal lamps and wooden shades, each requiring the use of grinding or cutting machine and sprayer. It takes 2 hours on grinding or cutting machine and 3 hours on sprayer to manufacture pedestal lamp. It takes 1 hour on grinding machine and 2 hour on sprayer to manufacture wooden shade. On any day, the sprayer is available for at most 20 hours, and the grinding machine for at most 12 hours. Again, here it is at most 12 hours. The profit from the sale of lamp is 5 rupees, and that from the shade is 3 rupees. Assuming that the manufacturer can sell all the lamps and shade that he produced, how should be the schedule his daily production in order to maximize the profit? Okay, so here there are the two products are there. They are pedestal lamp and wooden shade. So for that, here we'll take, let X denotes the number of pedestal lamp. Okay, pedestal lamp. Okay, and let Y denotes the number of wooden shades. Okay, wooden shades. Okay, these are the two products. Okay, now here we should make the table. So here I will write the product. What are those two products? Those two products are, here I will take this as a pedestal lamp. Pedestal lamp means here I will take PL. PL means pedestal lamp. That I will take that as a X. And here it is wooden shade. Wooden shade means here I will take this as a Y. And here they are using the machine. Okay, machine. And also they are using the sprayer. Okay, here I will write, are they requiring the use of grinding or cutting machine? So here I have written like this, grinding or cutting machine, and they are using one more there, that is a sprayer. Okay, now I have to go to the question. Okay, so to manufacture a pedestal lamp, here we'll write the availability of the machines. Okay, right. So okay, a cottage industry manufacturer pedestal lamp and wooden shade, each requiring the use of grinding or cutting machine and a sprayer. It takes 2 hours on grinding machine and 3 hours on sprayer to manufacture pedestal lamp. So to manufacture pedestal lamp, it takes 2 hours of grinding or cutting machine and 3 hours on sprayer to manufacture pedestal lamp. Similarly, it takes 1 hour on the grinding machine. 1 hour on the grinding machine and 1 hour on grinding or cutting machine and 2 hours on sprayer to manufacture wooden shade. Okay, so to manufacture a pedestal lamp, it take 2 hours on grinding or cutting machine and 3 hours on sprayer, and to manufacture a wooden shade, it is taking 1 hour on grinding or cutting machine and 2 hours on sprayer. Okay, now I have to write the availability. So on any day the sprayer is available for at most 20 hours. So sprayer is available for at most 20 hours means, at most means will take less than or equal to, and grinding machine or cutting machine for at most 12 hours. So again here it is at most means here will write less than or equal to. Okay, now we have to write the objective function. For that we have to take the profit. Okay, profit on pedestal lamp, that is how much is the profit on the pedestal lamp? The sale of the lamp is 5 rupees, so therefore this becomes what? 5x. Okay, profit on wooden shade, so profit on wooden shade how much? 3. Okay, so here we'll write this as 3 bar. Okay, here profit on pedestal lamp is 5x and profit on wooden shade is 3y, so therefore here we'll write the total profit that becomes z is equal to 5x plus 3y. Again here it is profit means we'll take maximum, so therefore maximize z is equal to 5x plus 3y. So this gives the objective function. So this gives the objective function of the LPP. Okay, so again this is the objective function. Now we will write the constraint. So therefore once again we'll write the mathematical formulation of this problem. So therefore maximize z is equal to how much? 5x plus 3y subjected to the conditions. What are those two conditions? So clearly 2x plus y which is less than or equal to 12, and this becomes what? 3x plus 2y which is less than or equal to 20. X is always more than or equal to 0, y is always more than or equal to 0. So now we got the mathematical formation of the problem. Okay, to get the maximum profit for the industry, how many of pedestal lamp and how many of wooden shade that industry should manufacture to get the maximum profit. So for that we are going to find the maximum or minimum value of this objective function by graphical method. So for that here we'll write the first equation. So that is here we'll write. So it is the first one is this one, 2x plus y which is less than or equal to 12. So write the inequality into equation, hence it becomes 2x plus y equal to 12. Okay, so now what it represents? So it represents a straight line. Okay, put x equal to 0, what is the value of y? 12. Put y equal to 0, what is the value of x? 6. So therefore what is the first point? That is 0 comma 12, and the second point is 6 comma 0. Now we'll go for verification. So we have to substitute the coordinate of the origin where we have to shade, below the line or above the line. So after substituting this, if you are getting true, then you have to shade below the line. So therefore here the inequality, 2x plus y less than or equal to 12, so therefore 0 is less than or equal to 12, it is a true. If it is true means what is the answer? Shade below the line. Okay, below the line. So first one is over. Now the second one. So what is the second one? So this is 3x plus 2y which is less than or equal to how much? 20. Write the inequality into equation, hence this becomes what? 3x plus 2y that is equal to 20. It is equal to 20. Okay, now what it represents? So it represents a straight line. So for that to substitute x equal to 0. Okay, substitute x equal to 0, what is the value of y? So clearly the value of y is 20. So what is the value of y? That is equal to 10. So the value of y equal to 0, then here you are getting 6.6 like that. So therefore point C, we'll take one more point, that is, so we'll take one more point, that is a C of 0 comma 10 and a D of 6.6 comma 0. Okay, now we have to go for verification. So for that you have to substitute the coordinate of the origin. Okay,
coordinate of the origin in this inequality, that is 3x plus 2y less than or equal to 20 means 0 is less than or equal to 20, hence it is true. Again, if it is true means again you have to shade below the line, shade below the line. Okay, next. Now we'll remove this one for that. Okay, now we have to find the maximum value by graphical method. Okay, now we have to find the solution by graphical method. Okay, like here, take the graph here. Okay, here it is x axis, here it is y axis, and here it is origin. So what are the points? So 0 comma 12 means we have to start from 2 2 4 6 8 10, it is 12. Again here it is 2 4 6 8 10, here it is 12. Okay, what is the first point? 0 comma 12. So 0 comma 12 means this is the point A, 0 comma 12. Okay, second point, what is the second point? 6 comma 0. So here this is the point 6 comma 0, join these two. So what it represents? So it represents the equation 2x plus y is equal to how much? 12. Okay, now where we have to shade? So shade below the line, so therefore here we will mark like this. Okay, okay, right. Now the second one is, which one is the second one? 0 comma 10. So 0 comma 10 means, so here we are getting, this is the point C, 0 comma 10. Okay, next, second one is 6.6 comma 6.6. this means here we are getting, so here point D, 6.6 comma 0, join these two. Okay, right. Now here we are getting the line, this is a 3x plus 2y, this is equal to 20. Again where we have to shade? Again we have to shade below the line. So here we are getting, okay, so here you have to observe carefully. Here you are getting the two reasons, here this is one reason and here one reason, but this is not a common and this is also not a common. So therefore which one is a common reason? So clearly this is the common reason. Okay, so both black and blue lines where they have coincide, so that gives the feasible reason. This is the feasible reason. Okay, so you have to draw carefully, or you have to shade. So you have to shade such that you should obtain only common reason. Okay, okay, right. So see here, this is the feasible region. Okay, feasible region. Okay, so what is the feasible region? Here it is O, here this is the point C, and here you are getting one more point, here I will call this as E, and this is the point B. Okay, so here we will write the feasible region. Which is the feasible region? Feasible region is O, here it is C, OC, here it is E, and here it is a B. So again clearly it is what? Bounded. So clearly it is a bounded. So therefore we already know that the feasible region is bounded, then its solutions always existed the corner point. So therefore what are the corner points? Corner points are 0, right, and C of 0 comma 10, and E you have to find, and B is, that is 6 comma 0. Okay, right. Now we have to find the coordinate of E. To find the coordinate of E, we have to solve the two intersecting lines. So here we'll write to find coordinate of E. Okay, solve those two equations are 2x plus y, this is equal to 12, and this is 3x plus 2y, this is equal to how much? 20. Okay, so here we should multiply 3, here we should multiply 2, so hence it becomes 6x plus 3y, this is equal to 36, and here it is 6x plus, here it is 4y, that is equal to 40. Okay, subtract these two, minus. These two will get cancelled. Here it is minus y is equal to minus 4. Therefore, what is the value of y? 4. If y equal to 4 means you have to substitute this in one of the equation. So, therefore, here it is 2x plus 4. Here I am substituting, that is equal to 8. So, clearly 2x equal to 8. So, what is the value of x? 4. Clearly the value of x equal to 4 means the coordinate of E are 4, 4. 4, 4. Okay, now we got the coordinates of all the corner points. Now we have to go for table. So the table is here, we'll write. Okay, we'll remove this one. Here the objective function z is equal to 5x plus 3y. Okay, remove this one. Now here we'll write the corner points. What are the corner points? 0, 0, and C of 0, 10, E of 4, 4, and one more is B of 6, 0. Okay. Now we have to substitute all these in this objective function. 0, here it is Z is equal to 30, here it is 20 plus 12, hence it is 32, Z is equal to 30. Okay, right. Now here it is 30. Okay, now we have to find the maximum out of all these. Here it is 0, 30, 32, and 30. So out of all these four, which one is maximum? So clearly 32 is the maximum. 32 is the maximum. So therefore your answer is, so the maximum profit is, so here we'll write the maximum of Z is equal to how much? 32 at E of 4, 4. So here what is the value of X? 4. What is the value of Y? 4. So it means that to get the maximum profit, that is 32 rupees, so the industry should manufacture 4 of how many we have to manufacture to get the maximum profit? The company or the industry should manufacture 4 number of pedestal lamp and 4 number of what? Wooden shades. Okay, to get the maximum profit of Z is equal to 32 rupees, the company should manufacture 4 number of pedestal lamp and 4 number of wooden shades. Like this we have to solve. Okay, now we'll go to the next question. Okay, this one. Okay. The next question is, this is the question number 7 from the exercise. This is the question number 7. Okay, a company manufactures two types of novelty souvenirs made up of plywood. Novelty souvenirs means that is nothing but momentum. For example, so they are like this. So these are called novelty 7 years, right? Novelty 7 years means momentum. Okay, right. So here there are the two types of the novelty 7 years. They are made from flywheel. 7 year of type A requires 5 minutes each for cutting and 10 minutes each for assembling. 7 year of type B requires 8 minutes each for cutting and 8 minutes each for assembling. There are 3 hours 20 minutes available for cutting and 4 hours for assembling. The profit is 5 rupees each for type A and 6 rupees each for type B. How many 7 year of each should company manufacturer in order to maximize the profit? Okay, so here we'll take, let X denotes the novelty 7 year of type A. 7 years of type A. There are the two novelty 7 years. So here I have taken X denotes the novelty 7 year of type A. Similarly, let Y denotes the novelty 7 year of type B. Is it right? Okay. Now I have to go to the table. So here the product. What are those products? Products. Okay. Products here will write novelty 7 year. 7 year of type A here I will write. 7 year of type B here I will write. Here I will call this as X and here I will call this as Y. Okay. Now. And here they are using the machine. So they are using the machine. Here I will take to make this. They are using the cutting and assembling. That here I have taken as a machine only. So here we will take this as a cutting machine and here we will take assembling. Okay, right. Now the availability for cutting and availability here will write availability. Okay. Now we have to go to the question. 7 year of type A requires 5 minutes each for cutting and 10 minutes each for assembling. So here it is 5 minute, here it is 10 minute to manufacturer 7 year of type A. Okay. Similarly, 7 year of type B requires 8 minute for cutting. Okay. 8 minute for cutting and how much? 8 minute for assembling. So to make a 7 year of type B, it takes 8 minutes for cutting and 8 minutes for assembly. Now availability. So availability, there are 3 hours 20 minutes available for cutting. So 3 hours. So here we'll take like this. 3 hours 20 minutes. 3 hours 20 minutes means I will write 3 into 60. So here it is, minute is there. We have to convert this also in minute. 3 into 60 means 180. 180 plus 20 means, so clearly it is a 200 minute. Okay. Now, for cutting, there are 4 hours. So clearly here it is a 4 hours means we'll write 4 into 60, that is equal to 240 minute. Okay. So here if they have given all these are in minute, we are also convert this into in also minute only. Okay. And here which sign here we have to take, whether we have to take less than or equal to or more than or equal to. For that there are only 3 hours 20 minutes means here we are getting only 3 hours 20 minutes means we will take less than or equal, because the availability of the time for cutting is only 3 hours 20 minutes, not more than this. Okay. Hence we will take less than or equal. Okay. Now we will write the profit on 7 year of type A. What is the profit on 7 year of type A? 5. So hence this becomes what? 5x. Again here it is profit. Profit on 7 year of type B. So what is the profit on 7 year of type B? That is 6 1. Okay. So here this is also profit. This is also profit. Means what is the total profit? Total profit, that is Z is equal to how much? 5x plus 6y. Again here profit. Profit means we should always get the profit maximize. Maximum of Z is equal to 5x plus 6y. Now we got the objective function. So again, once again we'll write the mathematical formation. Maximize Z is equal to how much? 5x plus 6y subjected to the conditions. What are those two conditions? So here we'll take 5x plus 8y, which is less than or equal to 200. Okay, and second one is 10x plus 8y, which is less than or equal to 240. Okay, and here x is always more than or equal to 0, y is always more than or equal to 0. Again, here this is the mathematical formation of the given problem. Okay, so this is the mathematical formation of this problem. Okay, now we have to find the solution by using the graph. For this, here we'll take the first one. So first inequality is this one, that is 5x plus 8y, which is less than or equal to how much? 200. Write the inequality into equation. So here it is 5x plus 8y, that is equal to how much? 200. So now what it represents? So it represents a straight line. To draw a straight line, we need the two points x and y. Put the value of x equal to y. So here we are getting 25. Okay, and put y equal to 0. Y equal to 0 means 5x is equal to 200 means, so here you are getting 40. Okay, the point A is 0 comma 25, point B is 40 comma 0. Okay, now we have to go for verification. So verification means where we have to shade. For that, here you should take the coordinate of the origin. Substitute this here. So here 5x plus 8y less than or equal to 200. So clearly 0 is less than or equal to 200. Hence it is true means we have to shade below the line. Okay, first one is over. Now we'll go to the second one, that is 10x plus 8y, that is less than or equal to 240. Write the inequality into equation, hence it becomes 10x plus 8y, that is equal to 240. Okay, now substitute x equal to 0. What is the value of y? Put x equal to 0, then the value of y is equal to 30. Okay, put y equal to 0, then the value of x equal to 24. Therefore the point C is 0 comma 30, point D is 24 comma 0. Okay, now I have to go for verification. Okay, verification means we have to take the coordinate of the origin. Okay, substitute this here, that is 10x plus 8y, which is less than or equal to 240. So clearly 0 is less than or equal to 240. Hence it is true. If it is true means where you have to shade? Again, for this line also you have to shade below the line. Below the line. Okay. Next. Now we are going to find the solution by using the graphical method. So for that, so here I'll remove this one. Okay, so that is a question. Now we have to find the solution by using the graph. So for that, here this is x axis and this is y axis, and here it is origin. While drawing the graph, you have to write the scale along x-axis and along y-axis. How many units you are taking, that you should write. Okay. And here, what is the first point? 0, 25 means we'll start with 5, 10, 15. Here it is 20, 25, 30, 35. Here it is 40. Okay. Here also, here it is 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, and here it is 40. Okay. What is the first point? 0, 25 means, so here we'll take, this is the point A, 0, 25. Okay. Second point is 40, 0 means, so here we are getting point B, that is 40, 0. Join these two. After drawing this line, you should write the equation of that line, 5x plus 8y, that is equal to how much? 200. Okay. Next, where you have to shade below the line. So here we'll shade this one. After this, we should write the common reason. Okay. Next, second one is this one, 0, 30. So 0, 30 means, so here you are getting point C, 0, 30. Point D is 24. So 24 means here we'll take, this is the point D, 24, 0. Again join these. Okay, write the equation of this line. So what is the equation of this line? That is 10x plus 8y. This is equal to how much? 240. Again, where you have to shade? Again below the line. So here right line. Okay. After this, you have to shade the common reason only. Okay. So here you are getting the three reasons. So this is one reason and this is one more reason. But these two are not a common reason. But this is the common reason, because where both the blue line and black line, they are intersected at this region, and so this is the common region. Okay, this is also called what? Feasible region. This region is also called a feasible region. Okay, this is the common region. So here we'll write, this is the feasible reason. Okay, right. So here we'll write the feasible reason. Feasible reason is, that is O, here it is A, here we'll mark this as E, and this is a D. Again, this feasible reason is what? Bounded. We already know that the feasible region is bounded, then its solutions always exist at the corner points. So here we'll write the corner points. What are the corner points? 0, 0, A of, this is 0, 25, E we have to find, and one more is D, that is 24, 0. Okay, now we have to find the coordinate of E. So for that, here we'll write to find coordinate of E. To find the coordinate of E, again we have to solve the two intersecting lines. So clearly it is how much? 5x plus, that is 5x plus 8y, that is equal to 200. Okay, right. And here it is 10x, 10x plus 8y, that is equal to 240. Okay, subtract these two. So directly here minus, and here it is minus. Again here plus 8y and minus 8y will get cancelled. So clearly here it is a minus of 5x. Minus of 5x is equal to minus of 40. What is the value of x? So clearly the value of x is equal to 8. Now I have to substitute the value of x equal to 8 in one of the two equation. So therefore here write 5x plus 8y, that is equal to 200. So here it is 5x, what is the value of x? 8, plus here it is 8y is equal to 200. Here it is 40 plus 8y is equal to 200. 8y is equal to 160. Again y is equal to, sorry, here it is 8y is equal to 200 minus of 40. Okay, here 8y is equal to how much? 8y is equal to 160, y is equal to 20. Okay, now we got the coordinate of e, that is 8 comma how much? 20. 8 comma 20. So here we'll write this is 8 comma 20. Okay, now we already know that the visible region is bounded, then it's then the maximum or minimum value of the objective function always exists at the corner point. So here we'll make the table. Okay, here we'll take table, here the corner point 0 comma 0. It will take objective function. Objective function is this one, 5x plus 6y. Okay, right. Here, and the corner points are e of 0 comma 25 and e of, that is e of 8 comma 20 and one more is 24 comma 0. 24 comma 0. Now substitute here, so what you are getting, z is equal to, here you are getting 0, okay, and here it is z is equal to, here it is 6 into 5, so 6 into 5 means so clearly it is 150, okay, and here it is z is equal to, here it is 40 plus here it is 120, so therefore so clearly it is 160. Okay, next, and here it is 24 into 5, so clearly 24 into 5 plus 6 into 0, so what is the value? So again here it is 24 into 5, so 24 into 5 means so clearly it is 120. Okay, now out of these values, here z equal to 0, z is equal to 150 and z is equal to 160 and z is equal to 120, out of all these which one is maximum? So clearly z is equal to 160 is the maximum. Okay, so therefore here we'll write the maximum profit. So here we'll write the remaining here maximum of z is equal to 160 rupees at the point E, that is 8 comma 20 means, so clearly what is the value of x? 8. What is the value of y? 20. So what x represents? So in this problem here we have take x as a, so 7 year of type A, so therefore here it is 7 year of type A, and here we'll take 7 year of type B. Okay, to get the maximum profit, z is equal to 160 rupees. So therefore the manufacturer or the company should manufactures 8 types of 7 year of type A and 20 pieces of 7 year of type B to get the maximum profit. Okay, so up to this we will complete this exercise also, and this topic also, and in this exercise 12.2, so question number 1 and question number 9 and question number 10, 1, 9 and 10, they are related to, here it is bounded, and they are related to unbounded region, but this year they have not, or they removed
the problems on unbounded region. So hence you have to practice only these only, and thank you. Okay.